How's it going, guys? I'm Steven Spence from Black Tide, and you are watching Shockwave TV. Be sure to check out our new album, Postmortem, in stores now. Right. We're here with Steven Spence of the Black Tide, Steve Fox, Shockwave Magazine. No, really good to be here with you, man.
Thanks for having me.
Not a problem. Thank you for accepting this. That was an opportunity for me. Always a learning experience to meet with new musicians, especially ones so young.
Thank you.
I'm actually the oldest guy in the band right now. I'm 23. But Gabriel, our singer, he's 18 now. So. Yeah. All right. I'm not the total young buck here. That's right. 23, a couple of months.
Okay, cool.
How's it feel to be reunited with the band?
Oh, it's great. Actually, that's funny that you asked that because, Avenged Sevenfold were one of the first bands that took us out, back in 2007. Became good friends with those guys and went overseas with them. Learned a lot from those guys. They taught us a lot about, living on the road. This whole tour, we're on the Rockstar Energy Drink, Uproar Festival. And it's great for us because we're reconnecting with a bunch of friends on the road. Bullet from Gaga are some of our best friends out here. And, a lot of the bands we've already toured with or we've known throughout the past few years. So it's great. It's like a family tour.
Being on the road so young and have torn for so long, it's like you're still learning stuff.
Oh, absolutely. Every day is a learning experience for me and everyone like that. So, we're fortunate, we're grateful that we can do that, especially with such acts like this.
I was reading and listening to some stuff back in the day before you were doing radio. Did you have a clue where that came from? What came from? The name Radio?
I mean, yeah, they just needed a name, they chose it, and then when I joined the band, it was still called Radio, technically, then we went to record our first album, and we were kind of nameless for a while, and we chose Black Tide, just we all liked it, there was a deeper meaning for it, but it was all superficial at that point, think about it, and then it's just Black Tide pretty much just came out to mean, it's us, it's what we are, it's our way of life, it's who we are.
I remember back in the day, it was the same kind of situation. We just needed a name, and we went with Unheard Of.
Okay.
I remember this one show specifically, it was a record actually. And I was like, hey everybody, we're Unheard Of. Yeah, I know that. Who the fuck are you?
Oh man. Yeah, I feel like you got the Negative Nancys out there, Debbie Downers. They'll be able to turn any positive thing or anything into a negative thing. You just gotta watch out for it. Try not to.
No. Chiggers all over the
field. Oh, shit.
What are chiggers?
The red dots get all over the knees, down around the ankles.
All right, thanks.
Girl, let you know.
I appreciate that. All right, watch out for the chiggers.
Yeah.
Apparently. I've got sandals on.
Good deal.
Yeah. So I'm going to have chiggers all over my toes.
Recently, wow, what was it, last week?
Yeah, it actually just came out, so that is Postmortem.
How does that differ from, Light From Above?
Well, it differs in that, we're much better musicians, we're much better songwriters, we changed individuals and a band collectively, and that we progress. I feel like all bands should progress, and it's just that, some people might see our progression as very drastic, from Light From Above to Postmortem. But it's really not, because I want to let people know that, some of the songs that were written on Life From Above, Gabriel wrote when he was 10. Now he's 18. So, at the forefront, if you're just looking at it, it might look like a pretty drastic change, but it's really not. Over 8 years, it's kind of gradual, And we just want to be true to who we are. We want to make music that we like and make music that we're going to be behind. If we're going to be playing it every day on the road, we want to be proud of it. And all we can do is be true to ourselves. And I know, not everyone's really digging the change from Life From Above. I'm not saying everyone is, but hopefully our fans, just love us for the musicians that we are and stick with us for the ride that we're going to take them on.
Exactly, and that's what it's about,
Right.
It's like, all of us here with Shockwave is all about taking the music for the music and the passion of the music.
Right.
It's not about, clicks and this and that.
Exactly.
It's about just what overall is good quality music.
Right.
Just spreading that. It's like music is almost turning into my new religion.
Absolutely.
The fans taking music for the music, they all have a lot of stuff in video games, Colin McRae, Dirt 2, Speed 2, Guitar Hero, Modern Hits, Shockwave in that one. Oh, Rock Band. Right, no, I got some downloadable content there. It's like I've noticed a lot of, you know, bands trying to get in there and get that, you know, larger success, you know, having their songs in video games, right? Like, do you find that to be a good news to gain fan base?
Oh, absolutely. It's a great means of getting our stuff out there to a different group entirely. I remember we played a show and we closed with Warriors in Time, one of our songs, and some kid came up and was like, "Yo, did you cover that song at the end of your set?" And I was like, "The Warriors of Time that we played?" He's like, "Yeah." And I'm like, "No, that's hard." He's like, "NHL, man, NHL 09. So it's cool to see the kind of people that come out and see what that does for you, because, I mean, I don't know, that kid wouldn't know of us unless he heard us on that video game. And just like a bunch of other video games, it pops up our plays, and it just it only helps. So it's very cool.
Like, I used to have this subscription to Xbox Magazine. They'd have, like, the demo discs with all that. There's a video for Shadows Falling, and that's how I got into that.
Right.
Actually, you know, otherwise, you know, it would have been a while before I got to the one that I did. And I actually had a chance to meet the bassist. I forgot how mad the time to release that. Yeah, that was a cool thing.
Yeah, man, it's definitely real. It's a great way of getting things out there. We've got a song, our new single, Bat Fire. It's actually featured in NHL, new NHL.
NHL 12,
yeah. So that's pretty cool. And Street Fighter vs. Tekken, we have a song called Honest Eyes in there. So it's great. We've got a great team of people, and people are coming up to us and asking for a song. So that's really cool.
And being here with you at Uproar Tour, right? I really wanted to ask this. It kind of was a face palm when I heard the lineup, but I think it was 09, like December 09, you kicked it off with All American Rejects and Take Me Back Sunday.
Right.
Like, how was that experience being so different in sound?
So different. You know, it was awesome though, because, like I said, like we want to think outside the box. We want to do things. We want to push our limits and see what we can do as a band. And, you know, playing a show like that. There were a lot more girls at the show than you can imagine. Like, you come to an Uproar Festival, there's not too many girls out here. Or, like, we played Hellfest in France and Spain. And not too many girls at those shows either.
Ozfest, so it was pretty cool. Number of years ago.
Ozfest, yeah. So it was cool to see the ratio over there. But, you know, we're friends with those guys. You know, we've known the Rejects for a while. So it's cool that they took us out for that. And then we met them and took back some of the guys, and they're really nice. Everyone's just, like, all the musicians backstage, there's no beef, you know what I mean? We all just realize we're doing the same thing and love the music. You know, it is what it is. You know, we might be a different genre, but I don't even like genres altogether. I think it's a box that you put yourself in when you label yourself. So I never want to label myself or limit myself when it comes to creativity. I don't think anybody should.
Like when you're saying about different tours and stuff, like I mentioned, I remember Ozfest. You guys won that a number of years ago. Y'all got taken off of the Jägermeister stage.
Right.
And it was like still any kind of resentment for that, even though you did get to like open main stage.
No resentment whatsoever. All the, you know, all those feelings left as soon as they invited us back onto the main stage. You know, you can imagine, like, group of kids just playing Ozfest main stage. You know, Gabriel was 14 years old, so we were just like ecstatic. It was a dream come true.
Probably an experience for him, kind of similar to Denzel Baltimore from this band, called Let the Monkey Go.
Okay.
At 15, he played Woodstock as the drummer for Barlow Funkadelic, All Stars. Him and his dad.
Awesome.
Yeah. It's just this whole huge, huge thing, just being so young. Like, I can't even think about it. You know, I remember my experience with, like, Record Theater coming out there. It's like a three-quarters packed house, like my third show, you know.
Right.
And it's just like, I can't imagine.
Yeah, as long as
that day,
as long as you have fun, it's a different lifestyle. You know, Gabriel grew up, you know, getting signed when he was 13 years old, being on the road at such a young age. It's definitely, it's tough, you know. You take for granted. I feel like I take for granted. We all sometimes take for granted, you know, living at home, building relationships with friends and family, you know. So he definitely sacrificed a lot to be where he is and to be where we are, inevitably. And I, you know, I was 18, so even that age was a little bit young, but at least I was, you know, a little bit, you know.
To follow any dream, and when you have a legitimate chance, there are sacrifices that you gotta take.
Absolutely.
You know, but it's all what sacrifices are worth it to you.
Right. And I think we're just very fortunate that we were able to find our passion and harness it and focus on it and work on it at such a young age. Because there's so many people out there that just don't know what to do. So, you know, we're really, you know, grateful about that.
It's a long, you know, 22 years to get into that little niche and start going toward, like, the direction that you really want to go. You're right, it is tough. You know, a lot of people really don't know. Even at, like, 30.
Right.
A lot of people don't know really where they want to go. You know, going back to school at 40, trying to get a career.
Right. It's awesome, but it's never too late. You know, everyone deserves happiness and fun.
Getting a little personal here, like, taking a different direction on things. It's like, you know, you probably were forced to mature, you know, a lot faster, you know, living life on the road, touring with the band and everything. Does that, you know, change, like, when you have your downtime, your you time, you know, has that changed how you spend that? How do you spend
that? Luckily, you know, if not, we don't really look at this as too much of a business, you know. I'm out here on the road with my best friends. Black Tide are my homies, and that's what it is. You know, we're not a band that's been put together. I love these dudes, and over the past 4 years, we've had our better ups and downs, but right now we're the strongest we've ever been. And fortunately, my relationships on the road are with these guys, you know. We all love each other, so it's cool to be out. I can't imagine being out with anybody else. So, you know, we're really lucky. So many bands just hate each other. And they go on stage and they play and they just get off and never see each other when they go home. And, you know, it's just business to them, which is, it's unfortunate. So, you know, we're really lucky in that sense.
Really appreciate you taking the time with us. And I wish you luck. Hopefully the camaraderie, the brotherly love, you know, comes out on stage and actually, like, come out here and show us the peace.
All right, man. Looking forward to it.
Appreciate it.